Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have already finished with the question number 1 of exercise 1.1 A part. In this class, we have to study about the B part as well as question number 2 and 3 of the NCERT exercise. Okay, so we are starting with the question number 1 B part. Okay, to see that. In the previous question, we have already studied that first step is that we have to find that which rational number is common. So you can see that 2 by 5 is common between them. So what we have to do, we have to move this part with the pair also. So 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 3 by 7 plus 1 by 14 multiply by 2 by 5. Now move this minus 1 by 6 multiply by 3 by 2. Students, we already know that we have applied the property which is called the commutative property, which says that a plus b is equal to b plus a. So over there we have to write, we have to mention that we have used the commutative property. So here we will write the commutative property. Now what we have to do, we have to take 2 by 5 as common. So 2 by 5 multiply, we have left with minus 3 by 7 and plus 1 by 14 minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2. Now 3 1s are 3 and 3 2s are will be 6. 2 by 5 multiply it. What should be the LCM of this 7 and 14? So it will be 14. Now what should be 14 divided by 7 will give you 2, and 2 multiplied by minus 3 will give you minus 6, plus 14 divided by 14 will give you 1, and 1 multiplied by 1 will be 1. Now minus 1 into 1 will be 1 and 2 2's will be 4. Now 2 by 5 multiplied by minus 6 plus 1 will be minus 5 upon 14 minus 1 by 4. Now we have to cancel it. So 5 1's are 5 and here we will get minus 1. 2 1's are 2 and 2 7's are will be 14. Now 1 into minus 1, 1 into minus 1 will be, friends, minus 1. So over there we will write minus 1 upon 7 minus 1 by 4 with n is equal to sign. Okay, now what should be the LCM of this? So 7 and 4, we have to find the LCM of this. So what should be the LCM of 7 and 4? We have to mention 7 and 4. Divide by 2, 7 and 2. Divide by 2, 7 and 1. Now 7, 1 and 1. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 7 will give you 28. So the LCM will be 28. Now over here we will mention this 28. Now 28 divided by this 7 will give you 4, and 4 into minus 1 will give you minus 4. So it will be minus 4. Now 28 divided by this 4 will give you 7, and 7 into minus 1 will give you minus 7. So answer will be minus 7. The total answer will be minus 11 upon 28, which is our final answer. Students, we have completed with our first question. So now we will start with our second question. It is like that. Okay, so we have to find the additive inverse in the second question. So question number second is that, just find the additive inverse of the following. Find the additive inverse of the following. Now student, what is the first question? See, x is equal to, our first question is x is equal to 2 by 8. Now, x is a rational number of this. We have to find the additive inverse of this. So we know that if we are having this, we have to change the sign. If we are having a positive rational number, we have to make it negative or vice versa. It means the opposite of it is also true. So if the rational number is a negative rational number, so we have to make it positive, or if it is positive, to make it negative. So we can write x plus x bar is equal to 0, where x denotes the rational number. And here x bar, and here x bar denotes the additive inverse. Okay, students, I have to rub this side. So, students, put the value of x over here. 2 by 8 plus x bar will give you 0. We know that the rule, if we are having a positive rational number, and when we will change the sign, it will become a negative rational number. So x bar is equal to 0 minus 2 by 8. Now 0 minus 2 by 8. So what should be the value of 0? The value of 0 is nothing. So x bar will give you minus 2 by 8. X bar will give you minus 2 by 8. Let's see what is the second question. Second question is minus 5 by 9. So x is equal to minus 5 by 9. By same rule we can use x plus x bar is equal to 0, where x bar is the additive inverse. So minus 5 by 9 plus x bar is equal to 0. This is minus. When we will change the side, it will become positive. So x bar is equal to 0 plus 5 by 9. And any number added to 0, it will give the number itself. So x bar is equal to 5 by 9. Students, we are having 3 more questions which you have to do with your own.